Thank you. And honorable panelists and dear friends, with the permission of the chairman, I would speak directly to the students. Because, so we have heard very nice and very good and thoughtful speeches. Only one question remains, that what should we do? What should we do? Now, before I get into that, I think one thought is, what do we want from all this? Whether it is from the constitution or from the elections or from secularism and so on, what do we want? From our side, we want good, clean governance. That we need to have a government and political system in place which will deliver good governance on behalf of the people. That is what our goal is. Your goal may be different. You know, some people want a particular candidate to win, particular political party to come, particular ideology to be in place. That's not our goal. Our goal is that we have a good, clean government which will deliver good governance. Now, if we are, that's what we are interested in. I'll just take a minute. We just conducted a survey with 13,000 people in Karnataka. And the report was released by the Chief Election Commissioner last week. What do people of Karnataka want? What is good governance? And we asked all these questions about constitution, about terrorism, about secularism, etc. Now, whether people are wise or otherwise, I'm not saying anything, but what do people of Karnataka want? They want good, clean drinking water. That is the number one priority. Peene ko paani chahiye. They want jobs. They want good transportation system. They want good schools, primary schools, government schools, good health care from the government. These are the things that the people want. But if you must be following the elections, the TV, what the politicians say, what the intellectuals say, these things are never discussed. Some people discuss very, very high things, and then some politicians are talking about something else. But what the people want is not being reflected in either the campaigns or when the governments come. So how do we make that happen? So that is the question number one. Now, to get to good governance, what are the challenges that we face? One of them, I think a few of them, both the speakers have mentioned. I'll mention a couple more. The misuse of money power. Now, we should understand a little bit, particularly our young friends, what is the problem with this money power? We think that somebody is rich, he is spending a lot of money, it is very good, and he or she can buy votes. Then the cynical people say people are clever, they take money from all parties and vote for the person of their choice, and so on and so forth. So many theories are there. But we ask a simple question, that if somebody spends crores of rupees in the election and wins, what will he or she do after they win the election? Will they do good governance? Because he has invested 5 crores, 10 crores in the election. Is he interested in good governance after winning? So we have an obvious structural flaw. The constitution and the law say you should not spend more than 28 lakhs, but nobody follows that law. Now we can say Supreme Court should do something, Election Commission should do something. Of course, we will definitely as citizens ask them to do something. But what should we do as citizens in this issue? Now behind all this money power, there is one uncomfortable truth that we are not willing to face. When a person goes to vote, whether it is for caste or for community or for money, nobody is putting a gun on his head saying, you vote for that person. Whatever it is, of their own free choice, they are voting there. So the uncomfortable truth is that people can be influenced. The people that we think of as our friends, they are all very clever, very intelligent, they cannot be bribed, they do not worry about their caste and community, they are all wonderful, ideal citizens. But the common people, they are very foolish. I mean, I'm just being sarcastic. They do not understand the implications of caste and community, they don't understand secularism, and they can be bought with votes and threats and so on and so forth. I do not know if this is true, But this is the assumption behind all this kind of analysis. So what should we do? Now, what the election commission should do, I think the election commissioner has spoken, but our stand always has been that the chief election commission, former chief election commissioner Dr. Qureshi was bold enough to say that why are you asking for permission? If something can be done, you should do it. So I think wherever there is prima facie evidence that huge amounts of money has been spent, we would say that the election should be countermanded. Now, how this money power plays out, also I think for our young friends, you should understand. It's not just a moral issue. Now, Bangalore is full of potholes, full of power cuts. There are problems with water, electricity. So many problems are there. You all are living with it. Now, this has a link with elections, black money, overspending and good governance. Because those who are spending money and winning elections, they are neither interested or sometimes not capable of delivering good governance. And if we go on voting for such people, then we have a problem. Of course, there is one issue I must point out to all of you, is that some structural changes are needed. There was a discussion about proportional representation, first past the post, and there are many other remedies that might be required, and then there are opinions on how to bring about that change, whether the law has to change, the constitution has to be changed, or it can be directly done, and so on. So I don't want to get into that, because as a voter, my problem is, whom should I vote for? So there are three candidates, I don't like anybody, whom should I vote for? So that's a big problem, I agree. But there has to be a voter awareness campaign, and for our young friends, you can try, you must be having your mobiles, just go to 56070, that's the number, 56070 is the address, and send a text message called MyNeta, M-Y-N-E-T-A, MyNeta space, the pin code, whichever pin code you are living in, and you will get details of all the MLAs and MPs. I think the power of social media, particularly WhatsApp and SMS and I don't know what all, I'm not much into that, Facebook and Twitter and so many things are there. I think people have to start using that information on the candidates, which is publicly available now. You can go to the ADR website, you can also go to Election Commission website, and details of every candidate are available. So, for example, I just got to know that the MLA from my constituency, his assets are worth 35 crores. Now, if I'm a good citizen, I'll say, okay, good, he's a prosperous person, but where did he get that money from? Should I vote for this person or not? Does he have any criminal cases? So, all this information is available, and I think the young people should look at that information, inform their friends. And we are also running some campaigns, and you can see it on our website, including some celebrities. One of them is a famous celebrity called Amir Khan, and he says in Hindi, ki is baar hum vaada karte hain ki jo hamare vote khareedne ka koshish karega use hargis vote nahi denge. And of course, it's available in Kannada and other languages, that those who are going to try and buy my vote, I will never vote for them. But that message is not for the people in the hall. What we need is volunteers from the young people who will reach that to the number of voters around Karnataka. From our side, we are definitely going to be doing that campaign. We are doing some campaigns in three districts in Mysore and so on, Hassan and in Coorg and also in Bangalore. And I will also mention one thing, because it is a youth power which has a potential. The first change after 1947 came through the youth power, when the first non-Congress government was voted out through a movement led by Jay Prakash Narayan, and without the youth it wouldn't have happened. But today now we have 21st century technology, so I'll leave you with one thought. We have something called an Election Watch Reporter, EWR. You can download it from the ADR website, Election Watch Reporter. And when you, as a concerned citizen, it's not only about me voting, it's not only about me registering myself and definitely voting, that is a good thing. But as an active concerned citizen, it is also about helping the election commission and the courts and the administration to improve the system. So what can we do with the Election Watch Reporter? If you go and cover any election, just walk around the streets and you find that liquor is being distributed, money is being distributed, huge campaigns are going on, which are obviously costing lakhs of rupees. You can take photographs and videos of that. Through now, the beauty is we have implemented the Whistleblower Act in our. So your name and your mobile number will be kept secret, but the geographic location, time, etc., and the authenticity will be maintained, and it will be directly uploaded, and we will definitely go to the courts and to the election commission. Because we are sick and tired of asking authorities to do something, it is something that we have to do. So there is a shop with a story that, you know, when we were kids, we used to ask that on a tree, there are 24 birds, and one fellow takes a gun and shoots one bird. He says, how many are remaining? He said, 23. He said, no, zero, because everybody goes. So we have to get a few elections countermanded because of not entire country, just a few. And we are going to concentrate on what we call red alert constituencies, where from the past data, we have a lot of data where we know that these kind of activities are going on, particularly appeals based on caste or religion or overspending of money. And we will try our best to get those elections countermanded, and we need the help of the young people to do it. You see, my hair has grown gray, but I might be one of the youngest persons other than Father Augustine who's sitting there. Don't depend on people with white hair. You people, because they will only talk, they will give you big speeches, tell you about history and all. Karne ka kya hai, aap logon ko karna hai. So, I hope that you will do something. And I would like to thank FDCA and St. Joseph's College for giving us this opportunity. Thank you.